I now call upon our honorary member to be our chief guest, Dr. S. Subramaniam, to address the gathering. Mark my words, if you haven't heard it before, you'll be really inspired.
Good morning, my young friends. At the outset, I would like to thank the President, Executive Committee, and the members of Maratha Chamber of Commerce Madras for asking me to participate in this monthly meet and share my experiences as an entrepreneur. I have a feeling that I am carrying coal to Newcastle. Already I am seeing many entrepreneurs here, and it's like cold and ulekalathil oosi kondu povan pol. Anyway, I am going to share my experiences and a few things we can get out of it. So all know, men are shaped by their experiences. In the early years of my life, had a few experiences which shaped and changed my attitude to life. At the turn of the century, our family was one of the richest in our village. It was told it was about 5 lakhs. That's a lot of money. 1905, and my grandfather had a daughter and 5 sons. They grew up and got married, but my grandfather died at the age of 46 due to diabetes. So my father was 21 years old and my uncle was 23 elder. Both of them were carrying out the business in Colombo, but somehow those days sons of rich people get into ways, and that was quite common in Chettiar community also. So my uncle were given to gambling, girls and drinks. So that resulted in partition of our family. That was a sad thing to happen. But after the partition, that was in the year 1941, that was the year I was born. I must say that my uncle changed the man afterwards. He became a very loving person, and we all of us loved him and respected him. The byproduct of partition was suspicion, jealousy, enmity, and hatred among our 5 families. That has left a deep impression on me. I resolved that I will not yield to gambling, girls, and drinks in my life. But already Sundara has mentioned, I was sent to Colombo for studies in 1949. For a couple of years I was in Kampala and 5 years I was in Colombo. In 1951, Kirpananda Varia gave a discourse on Ramayana for 21 days in Murugan Temple, Jindipiti, Colombo. It left definitely a lasting impression on me at that age. You all know that Rama personifies love, valor, patience, fidelity, love and respect for parents, gurus and elders. Those years, kings were marrying many women. In fact, his father Dasaratha supposed to have married 60,000 women. But Rama was different. This is in our culture. Somerset Maugham says, nothing are the godmen of India more detrite than in their contention that chastity intensely enhances the power of the spirit. This is true. It definitely enhances the power of the spirit. When Kaikeyi asked Rama to go to the forest, Kamban was wordless. He exclaims, இப்பொழுது எம்முனோரால் எம்புதற்கு எளிதே செப்பரும் குணத்திராமன் திருமுகச் செவி நோக்கு அந்த அலர்ந்த செந்தாமரையை வென்றதம்மா. So this was the reaction of Rama. But this is not. Normal human reaction. But Rama was God in human form. But we can try to practice a mental balance, equipoise. Greeks call it stoicism. Reacting the same way to pain and pressure. Then I passed SSLT and I was waiting for the PUC. During the period, I came across the Gandhi's biography, autobiography, translated in English by Mahadev Desai. My experiments with truth. This impressed me even today. Gandhi became my hero. His teachings, truth and non-violence, has relevance even today. The nearest Kural that comes to my mind is Ondraha Nalladu Kollamai Matradan Pinsara Poyyamai Nandar. After my Colombo studies, I came to India to do my 10th standard and SSLT in my village, Salachi Kalasani, started by famous Kanmuthu Thyara Engineer. I topped SSLT at the district level as well. And easily I got a stipend, free education in Thyaraja College for PUC as the first prize student was given a free education in Thyaraja College. So I did my PUC, I got high marks, and then I got into MBBS in Madras Medical College. That's definitely a prestigious medical college in any part of the world. And actually I wanted only a Madurai Medical College, but somehow I got Madras Medical College. That really has changed my life to a great extent. I was a studious student, I got medals. Then this helped me to get MD General Medicine easily, because those days getting a seat in MD is very difficult. My professor Dr. K. Ramachandra was impressed with my work as a student, as a house surgeon and as a senior house surgeon. So and the selection committee was there, so he selected me in general medicine. I was with him. During my senior house surgeon days, I got married. I lived with my wife in Tinagar for a year. Then once I was selected to MD, I thought it's not possible to study properly with a family on. So I sent my wife to village, and for 2 years I was in the hostel. In those 2 years, only once I went to village for a week. It was hard work. 8 o'clock we had to be in the ward, and till 4 o'clock we will be in the ward. And then we clicked 6 hours of studies throughout the period. So we had a very good knowledge about clinical medicine as well as theoretical medicine, those 2 years. Actually, for any doctor, that's the basis of his clinical knowledge and application. There were 40 students applied and only 4 passed, and I came first. I requested my professor Dr. K. Ramachandra to be posted in Madras Medical College as his assistant. But he was not very powerful at the time, so he said, it's not possible. So the DME gave me a post in Tanjavur Medical College. It was a blessing in disguise. Tanjavur Medical College is a newly won. In fact, that was started in the year I joined MBBS. At the time, they had 2 hospitals, one in the city town, Rajamrasar Hospital. That was an old building with patients crowded everywhere. Whereas, because of the medical college, they built a new one, and that was really like a private hospital. So those days, the chief doctors were admitting patients in the new hospital after getting 25 rupees. So it's a consultant practice. They see their patients in the private clinic and admitted them in the government hospitals. That was the situation then. 25 rupees per week. Then we have to discharge them within 6 days, so that the next admission day we have to prepare for admissions. 25 rupees at that time is a good money. With 3 consultations, you can get a gold coin those years. I decided not to do that. And I have very good memories of Tanjavur, because I matured into a good clinician, because we were the only people taking care of the patients, outpatient as well as inpatients. The chiefs were not very much bothered about it. Many of them are old and not very much interested in teaching.
So we are fresh from studies, so we are interested in teaching, and many students flocked us, our clinics. During this period, I became the family doctor of Mopanas, Vandeyas, and Madhukur Raja. And Madhukur Raja was married to a daughter of Raja of Ramnath, so he came into contact with Ramnath Raja family also. I developed a decent practice slowly and steadily, but then I wanted to do specialization. I thought MD is not enough, so I wanted to do cardiology in those years, that is in